Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing great. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about make results command. So make results command are very useful when you want to create some dummy data or because you want to create some test data and you want to just, you know, play around with the data. So whatever result which is generated by make results are the result which is just kept in memory. It is not stored anywhere or not indexed. Okay, so for example, if you just run make results, it is just going to return you one time. Okay, and then you can also specify count equal to, you know, whatever number of events which you want to generate. So for example, let's say if I say count equal to 20, in that case it is going to generate 20 events. And also you can see that time for all of these are same, so that's the reason it may not be useful for you know, using it as it is. And you may want to tweak it a bit in order to, you know, generate time, for example, maybe, you know, in descending order based on minute by minute or whatever. Okay, so for that what you can do is you can use a stream stats. And what stream stats does is it is going to give you actually a count. Okay, so it's more like a serial number against each of the events. So for example, if I'm running it, you can see that we are going to have a field which is going to be called count. And also you can see here we have basically, you know, I call it serial number because just counting 1 2 3 4 up to 20, we have 20 events. Now what we can do is we can also use eval statement. So with eval statement we'll be able to modify the time. So for example, I can say time equal to let's say time plus I want to add this, you know, whatever the value here is in the count, I want to add that value in time. So by default underscore time is in epoch. Okay, so what it means is that whatever value you add here is going to be in seconds. So in this case I'm just going to say time plus count. And in this case also notice here that it is going to show us future value. So if you want to show past value, in that case rather than plus you can use minus. So let's use minus and then run it and let's see what is the data we get this time. Okay, so now you can see we have data of 23, 50, 36, which is now, and then all the remaining data is reduced by 1 second. Okay, so if you want to reduce all of this time by 1 minute, in that case you can what you can do is you can do minus count and you can multiply this count by 60. Okay, because this count is actually representing seconds, so if you multiply it by 60 it is going to become minutes. So let's run this and let's see what is the data which we see this time. Okay, so here you can see we have 2350, then we have data for 2349 and so on, and we in total we have 20 events. Now you may also want to produce some more columns, so you can do that as well. For example, what we can do is one thing which I forgot to mention is that you need to make sure that make results is the first command. Okay, you cannot use make results later on. For example, I cannot just cut it and put it here. Okay, it is not going to work. It is going to give us errors. So make sure must be the first command. Yeah, make results should be the first command. And now we are going to, let's say, add some value. So I'm gonna say eval and let's say we add counter and we call it, I'm going to say 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10. Okay, and I'm also going to get rid of, okay, let's run it now and see how it works and then we are going to just change it a bit. So for example, here you can see we get data like this. Okay, so I'm not really interested in this data, so first thing I'm just going to get rid of count. And once we get rid of count and we run it again, then let's see how is the data at this time. So for example, now we get this kind of data. Okay, so one thing which I'm gonna do is I'm gonna break this data with space. Okay, so I want to show it not in a single row, I want to show each of the value in a different row. Okay, so for that, a simple thing which we can do is we can say eval and we can say counter equal to, and we want to use split function, we want to split counter column with value of space. And let's run it now, and if we run it now it should be showing us like this. Okay, so it has broken up everything, but it is showing everything under one row. So now we need to use mv expand, so we can say mv expand and we can say counter because this is the name of the column. Okay, now run it again, and this time we should be able to see all the values in a different row. Okay, so you can see now we have some test data which is already generated, which is having, you know, a counter column and count column and time column. And again, you can use this kind of data, or you can generate this kind of data for various purpose. Maybe you want to do some testing, or maybe you just want to test some syntax of some of the functions which is available in Splunk, or maybe you want to test some commands. So there can be any reason for which you want to make use of make results command. So that's it in this video. See you again in the next video.